just keep losing my beat. I'm okay, I'm alright. Ain't gonna miss no defeat. I just gotta get out of this prison cell. One day I'm gonna be free, Lord. Somebody, 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 can anybody find me?
Nothing a little burping will cure. Up?
Come on, all the way. I gotta work on that.
Whoa! Hello, ladies. Lucinda.
Oh, she gives the worst gifts.
Not if she can't find the baby. Lucinda here. Fairy par excellence. Now, where's the baby?
At her grandmother's.
At her grandmother's. For a walk. She's walking at her grandmother's.
Well, either way, as you can see, she's not here. Oh, look. She's back.
All right. Aww. What shall we give this beautiful little child today? What's her name again?
Ella.
Ah, Ella of Frill.
Not a very well-behaved little stinker, is she?
Quiet, please. I can't concentrate here. Ella of Frill, I give you the gift of obedience. Now go to sleep. Now, wake up. Isn't it wonderful?
No, it's terrible. It's a terrible gift to have to do what you're told. Take it back.
I have a no return policy. And if you're going to be ungrateful, I can always turn her into a squirrel instead.
A squirrel?
No, obedience is a lovely gift.
This thing go to trial. This woman had her arm eaten by an alligator in a backyard. She wears a stump at a jury. She could get $10 million. What's the look?
Going to Panko tomorrow, I told you.
Oh, Jesus, Dahlia, not tomorrow. I got enough problems trying to get in there with Ken. No, I just mean I really want to try and handle this. Settle it. You know, arbitrate, like a real lawyer. I'm actually kind of good at this. Negotiating, working the numbers, working the angles.
But I can help you!
I got Aubrey for that. I mean, she's a paralegal. She's got a legal education.
I know what paralegal means! Except I didn't go to school, Wayne. I don't have a law degree or an MBA. Did you hear yourself before, by the way? What am I supposed to do while you were so busy working the numbers and the angles? Sit at home and clip coupons? You know, as it turns out, I do not know what a paralegal is, Wayne. And I'll
streets of some old ghost town. I tried to believe in God and James Dean, but Hollywood sold out. Saw all of the saints lock up the gates I could not enter. Walked into the flames, called out your name, but there was no answer. And now I know my heart is a ghost town. My heart is a ghost town.
sweet.
I thought, I got it made. I married a doctor. And then you realize you're going to wake up every day to the same hairy ears, same slightly deformed fungal toenail. And you're going to have to listen to that weird ear throat clearing sound they make every day until you are dead.
And the same penis. I may literally never see another penis again. Unless it's a small child. Or if you get sexually assaulted. And Josh's is lovely. You know, we have an incredible sex life, but that's not the point. You know, I love Michael Jackson's Off the Wall album, but I wouldn't necessarily want to only listen to that for the rest of my life.
Yeah. Oh, honey, I've been there. I mean, you'll listen to it a lot in the beginning. You'll listen to it in all different sorts of places. You'll listen to it in the car, in the disabled toilet cubicle, in the McDonald's in Egham, in your unconscious granny's hospital room.
Granny Merritt.
That's what she would have wanted. But then, you know, you're just going to get to the point where you're not that bothered about listening to music at all. You just play it on birthdays or when you're very, very drunk. Or if someone shows you a Justin Bieber video when you're in the office and, you know, all you can then think about is that.
Isn't he, like, 15?
Oh, he'd know what to do. I'd ruin Bieber.
Satire. And now I know my heart is a ghost town.